Welcome back here on BRGY. And you're still hanging out with me, Jay Miranda, together with our Bikada Kiara. And BFAM, as promised, all out ang Monday natin this week, BFAM. Dahil makakasama natin ang director and cast of the film, Take Me to Banaue. And they're all ready to speak out and say it here on Saucy.
Welcome in the studio, the leading lady in the film Take Me to Banaue, Maureen Robowitz.
Hello. Hi Maureen, welcome to BRGY.
Welcome
to our little home here at
BRGY. We're so happy to have you.
Feel at home.
Thank you. Ayan. Thank you so much for having me.
Kumusta naman, Maureen? How's your 2023 so far?
Great. I actually came from LA, so I was in LA just a week ago. Literally, so just a week ago. Really.
Oh my goodness.
And I had to travel to the Philippines for an event, which was yesterday.
Mm-hmm. Jam packed that day schedule.
But thank you for making time for us here at BRGY.
Yes, makakasama rin natin ngayon sa ating all out kwentuhan, the cast and the director of Take Me to Banaue. Let's all welcome live via Zoom Brandon Mello and Filipino American director Danny Aguilar.
Good morning there in Manila. Good evening here in Texas.
First of all, congratulations on the successful private screening of Take Me to Banaue. So, how does it feel getting such a warm reception for your film?
Well, it's just a very overwhelming kind of experience. So, I'm just kind of soaking all in. This film means a lot to me because this is my first film that shot outside of the US. So now that it's all coming together, it's very overwhelming because of the response of our kababayan, not only in the Philippines, but also especially here in the US.
Yes, how about Brandon?
It's a surreal experience. We've been working on this film for the past 2 years, so it's incredible now that everyone is able to see it and we're able to share it with the world. I definitely educated myself on the Philippines, just understanding, you know, the history, where it started, understanding more of the culture. But really, I was able to learn the most just by being there.
Derek, how important is it for you to be able to showcase Filipino excellence in your stories?
I co-wrote the screenplay, so I put a lot of it in terms of my experience. I spent about 7 years in the Cordillera region, so that location is very dear to me, and I really felt that, you know, at some point I have the obligation to kind of showcase the beauty of the country. And a lot of people don't know that Banaue is considered as the eighth wonder of the world. So when a lot of Americans, non-Filipinos, think about the Philippines, they think about beautiful beach, white sand, and I'm like, wait a minute, there's other part of the country, other landscape that are far more beautiful. And so that's where I decided to kind of create these stories to be able to showcase the Banaue, the northern part of the Philippines, but more importantly, the Filipino culture, the Lapu'a family and traditions and customs of the Philippines.
But of course, before we start our kwentuhan here, let me just ask first, no, kailan ang magiging premiere naman niya here in the Philippines? Because I'm sure there's a lot of BFAMs out there who would love to watch the film as well.
We're still working on the schedule, basically. So hopefully sometime before summer. Our target is maybe, you know, about April or May time frame, but that's really contingent upon the scheduling. But we're excited to have a screening in Manila, hopefully sometime soon.
For you, were you able to learn something new?
Well, I actually grew up with the Filipino culture.
Yeah.
Because my mom was, even though I grew up in Saudi Arabia, actually, I lived there for 12 years and I lived in Germany. But my mom always made sure for us to know the culture. Mm-hmm. And so when I lived here, I learned more about the Philippines. But here in the movie, Take Me to Banaue, Grace is actually from Banaue. Oh. So she's Ifugao and she had to speak Tuwali. So I was able to learn a new,
a new dialect.
Yes. I was able to immerse myself in Banaue and learn about the culture. And that was a very different experience. Actually, Direk Dani said, oh, you actually sound better speaking Tuwali than Tagalog.
You mastered it more.
Yeah, I was able to master it. And so, yeah, I was able to, you know, learn about the Pugao people. Mm-hmm. And it's definitely a very nice culture. And I was able to do it when I was in Banaue.
Now, let's look about Brandon. How were you able to prepare for your role?
I had to do a good amount of research into my character is an engineer and also has alexithymia. So I had to talk to engineers and people who have alexithymia, kind of understand, you know, what that's like and what's going through your brain and, you know, how they engage with people. It was an incredible process.
What's next after Banaue? Have you got another like place in the Philippines in mind?
Well, that's a good question. I'm actually trying to see if we can write a sequel. It would be really nice to see Hank and Grace meeting together in America, and you know, we'll find out a lot of the challenges of what they have to overcome and a lot of the conflicts. So that would be really good to kind of continue that story. But other than that, I have another one that I'm kind of conceptualizing in relation to you know, highlighting parts of the country as well, but we'll see.
What about you, Maureen? Were there any memorable experiences during the shoot of the film?
I felt very comfortable and very at home with everybody. We were there, we were together for like 3 weeks. And so, of course, like I'm new to being on set and, but everybody's just so friendly and you're just having fun. It doesn't feel like work. I'm just so glad that I was able to have like this family. Mm-hmm.
But yeah, B-Fam, I hope you're learning a lot about the film. Now, mm-hmm. of course, tuloy-tuloy lang ang all-out kwentuhan natin with the cast and director of Take Me to Banaue. When we return, samahan nyo kaming alamin kung ano-ano naman kaya ang na-explore at natutunan ni Brandon from the Filipino co-stars. Tinuruan din kaya sila mag-Tagalog ni Maureen? Nako, alamin natin yan sa pagbabalik ng BRGY.
Hi, I'm Raven Rigor, and ano yung gagawin ko if ever hindi na ako kinausap ng friend ko, hindi na, ayaw na makipag-hangout sa akin, I would feel really sad, pero tatanungin ko siya directly ano yung problem, kasi I tend to overthink a lot. So, I think kung mag-end man yung friendship, gusto ko na pag-usapan, or if may chance pang masave, then that's better. At least, nagkaroon kami ng chance to try and make amends.